What is the best AI content writer? Well, that's an interesting question and one that I was looking to find the answer to. For me, at the moment, I'm using three different AI content creation tools. I use ChatGPT along with the AI PRM extension within Chrome. That works pretty well. For ease of use and kind of high-speed content creation, I use Koala, which of course I've done a video on that in the past. Go check it out if you haven't watched it already. And the third bit of software that I've been checking out and that I really do enjoy using, and I'm gonna be doing a video on it real soon, is autoblogging.ai. And if you've not heard of that, you'll find a link to that below. Go check it out. So that's what I'm using, but I wanted to know, what is the best AI content writer? And I thought the best way to find out would be to ask some of my fellow YouTubers and Twitterers and other SEO experts and niche site owners, all those people, you know. I thought I'd ask them, you know, what is your favorite AI content tool and what are you using right now? And quite a few of them came back with some great answers and some great insights into what they're doing with these tools right now, and indeed which tools they believe are the best. So I think that's enough of me. Let's find out what they said.
Okay, so the AI writing tool that I'm liking the most at the moment is Reword. So I like this more than a lot of the other tools because I think that it combines everything that you need into one tool, in that a lot of the other ones, I think they sell you on like that you can have it all at once. You can click one button and it works. But I don't think that the future of AI writing is going to be that way, because it's just not, it's not human. It's not impacted by what you're doing, and it's not, there's no skill. Anyone, you have no unique selling point if anyone can click a button and have exactly the same thing as you. So your moat is that you have the X factor, you understand what works, you understand, you've written 1,000 articles to know just intuitively, studied the algorithm, got feedback and measured what works and what ranks and what doesn't. And now based on that, you can see what you'd change and what things that you'd need to change from like an AI article to know what works. As a result, good SEOs create good AI content and bad SEOs will create bad AI content. I don't think that AI is going to take bad or good people's jobs. It will take bad people's jobs, and it will mean the bar of quality is higher. What I like about Reword is that it sort of combines everything you need as an actual SEO with all the AI stuff that can save you time and manual labor. A lot of it is research and data finding. So to complement you writing, and this is Reword's tool, this is an example article that I was writing recently for the Lasso blog. And so is affiliate marketing worth it? You also have this, you know, you've also got the typical, you know, the surfer thing with what you're supposed to have, what you're not to have. Reader intent, which is really good because all of these are very relevant to worth it. Generally, is X worth it? Is pros and cons? How much money can you make? Is there risk? Those sorts of things. So you have all of those. It will tell you intents, which is really useful. If you're working collaboratively, there's comments. But what I like most is this. This saves me already time. A lot of these things are done in the research process, and research makes good articles. Research can also mean you write articles quicker, because often half an hour of really intense research can save you an hour's writing, because you just come with the facts and you can write clearly and concisely. Less editing, less writer's block, ready to go. And so Reword has built these custom things that help you quicker than ever get the information you need, and not just in writing stuff. You know, I can just go, you know, command, write a good intro to an article on, I can do this, right? And it'll be whatever. That's a bad prompt, so you probably won't get anything incredible. And again, AI is really driven by how good your prompts are. But let's say that I wanted to show that I know my stuff, as I have in this intro here, right? I've written by the numbers and I've included stats over how much it's worth, just as, you know, a quick thing to start off with. I might want to go, what statistics could be relative to the topic? So now I've instantly got this one here. You can click through, but also just generally publish it here. Now I've got this stat here. Affiliate marketing spending is expected to reach 8.2 billion by 2022. That's a useful stat in my intro. Anything else? You know, average order value is $65. Those are interesting things that I would have perhaps included that I've saved myself time with now. Other things you could do, like what expert quotes, instantly it will find you relevant quotes. Now, obviously, it will use things that are more readily available. You'll have a lot of Neil Patel quotes and things like that. But it's very useful for saving time. There are other like related topics it will give you, like what is affiliate marketing, how does it work, that you might want to stick in an intro, useful things like that, other titles, any facts my reader should be aware of. And it's useful, designed to save you time and shorten the research process and generally make your life easier. So I think this is the future of AI writers that work to create good human content, because this allows you to short circuit and accelerate the real human process by automating the bits that used to be like painstakingly and can be automated by humans, aka the research. And obviously, you should do some research as well, because that's how you get the actual insights to be able to write confidently and understand your topic best possible. But this can help with adding certain bits that add that cherry on top that make it better. I also think that these things act like a poker HUD, a heads-up display that, like, if you've ever played online poker, they basically like give you the stats and help memorize things where humans aren't good at memorizing large amounts of data. Computers are very good at storing that. And so you kind of turn it into a heads-up display that gives you all the information you need on the data you need, such as stats, expert quotes, and everything else. So you can do the thing that humans do well, which is be creative, understand your audience, understand the specific psychology behind the article, and create the best possible content faster than ever to the highest possible quality. And so that's why I think this is the best AI writing tool that I'm using at the moment. Also, you know, as well as an AI writer, it can also train itself on your content if you plug your GSC in. That's your choice to do as well, which is, I think, is a cool thing. And I know that Cal, who runs Reword, is adding a lot of development features on at the moment. So my pick is Reword. Hopefully this is helpful, and cheers. Bye.
Guys, Kazra at Searcheroo here. Now, my favorite content writing tool is autoblogging.ai. I have personally tested out various other AI writing tools, and I think autoblogging blows a lot of the other ones out of the water. I believe that it gives the best FAQs and the content score from the word go is super good. And also, when it comes to ranking snippets, it gives very concise answers, which is super important. So, the more concise your answers are when it comes to snippets, obviously, it becomes an easier snippet to essentially get. I also think that the costing is very good, in comparison to a lot of the other AI writing tools out there. And also the plagiarism as well. So, the plagiarism, if you actually check it, it's super good in comparison to a few of the other AI writing tools. So yeah, I think that autoblogging.ai is the best writing tool out there.
So my favorite AI writer might be a little bit different from the rest. What I like doing is I like using this Chrome extension called Harpa.ai, and I like to turn my personal videos into blog posts directly in ChatGPT with this extension. All I have to do is load up an old video of mine, and we have one right here, and then click on the extension and then add a slash, and I can either type in compose, which will write a full-on article, or outrank SEO article, which is a prompt that has been purposefully built to write SEO content. So all I have to do then is just tell the extension to find the transcript of my YouTube video. So it's also important to make sure that that YouTube video has a transcript. If it doesn't, it won't work. But once it does, all you have to do is whatever, you can include your company name if you'd like. I'm just going to say no, and off it goes. It's now writing a pretty solid SEO article based on my video without any real input from me. Now, I would still definitely recommend looking over it, editing it, making sure that it's perfectly legible. But anyway, that's my favorite AI writing tool.
Hey, I'm Doug Cunnington from Niche Site Project. Alex, thanks for inviting me. You want to know what the best AI article writer is, and I have probably an uninformed and unsatisfying answer. So first off, I haven't tried all of the tools out there. So that's an issue, number one. There's so many out there, and I literally get two emails a day. Someone has launched a new AI article writer of some kind. There's a ton of them out there, so it's really hard to figure out which one is the best. So a video like this is fantastic to help people narrow it down. If people don't know me, I'm a little bit lazy, and I don't want to try to learn about all the new tools that are out there. Some of them have really great marketing around them, and it's really hard to figure out, you know, which one I should even try. Because I am a lazy person, I have typically, you know, number one, just been using ChatGPT and Bard. So that's about it. The other thing is I have not been publishing articles written by AI. I don't write too much. If I am consuming, if I'm producing content, typically I am doing a podcast or a video, in which case ChatGPT or Bard does a very good job to create an outline or maybe a set of questions for someone I'm going to interview. So that works really well. I've played around and tested and actually just created articles from ChatGPT or Bard purely for creating videos, not to actually publish. So my opinion, I stick to the simple stuff. I use ChatGPT. I know it's not fully optimized around, you know, writing an article. It's much more general, but ChatGPT was the first AI tool that worked really well for me. And I was able to do research, get an outline, ask about how I could improve an article or a section of writing. And that worked really well for me. And I've stuck to it because I am not doing this at scale. So I know actually many of my friends have tools that can write an article. You just put in a keyword, maybe a little bit of other information, and it'll spit out an article on the other side. I don't currently have a need to do that. I have an actual human writer that does some writing for me, and that's it. So I'm not trying to solve the problem. I think it'll be interesting to see how websites that have used AI writers almost exclusively, I wonder how they're going to fare in a year or 2 years or, you know, even longer, right? Those articles may or may not be really valuable to the end user, especially if the cost and the effort required for creating, say, 2,000 or 4,000 articles is really low and it's really cheap to do that, then everyone will do it. So what do we lean on then? How does Google know? Like, what value can you add for the visitor then? So it's a toss-up. I vote for ChatGPT.
Invite me on your channel to talk about the best and my favorite AI tools. I do use AI tools in my business, although at the moment it's still quite a small part of my process. I still do have human writers. We do use AI to help create a first draft copy. And you will hear me mention that word first draft because we do not enter a keyword or a topic into an AI tool, let it generate some content and hit publish on it. We are not doing that at the moment. We basically just use it as a method to create an outline so we can create some subcategories and some headings that maybe our writers can use in their research. And it gives us that first draft copy, which we can then take away and actually research in more detail, but it gives us a head start on creating content. So we find it a helpful way to crank out ideas and shape the form of our content right from the very start, but we don't use it as a 100% print, click, publish type AI tool. The second thing we're using AI for at the moment is for imagery. We're using Midjourney, and we're also using a tool inside Canva. Yes, Canva does have AI technology inside it, and we're using some of the tools in there to play around with imagery and see if we can make them as original as possible or create something quite unique and not seen before. We're using imagery quite a bit, and I think AI is going to play a really big part in imagery and video content in the near future. I mean, I know companies like Adobe already have a program where you can physically drop in some images and some video clips, and it will do everything for you. The AI technology will take over and it will edit, it will format your videos, and it pretty much covers the job of a videographer, which is insane to think we're at that point right now compared to 2 years ago that wasn't even in the pipeline. But if we're going to talk about my favorite AI tools, I think it's the ones that's not even been developed yet. I think in our industry, it plays a tiny, tiny part. It is growing and growing, and it is slowly creeping into our industry. But I think we've only touched the tip of the iceberg, if I'm being honest. And where we are now compared to a year ago is incredibly different. And I think in another year's time, it will be even more so. So I think my favorite tools probably haven't even been developed yet. I'm excited to see what's going to happen. We just need to adapt, evolve, and learn. if we just ignore AI tools, we will get walked all over. Our industry will be taken over by people who know how to use these tools. And that's what I'm teaching my team and myself at the moment, is the skills needed to get the most out of these AI tools. Currently, a lot of the tools that's out there, if you do not know how to create good prompts and good instructions, you will get rubbish out of those tools. You need to learn how to use those tools properly. And if you do, they can help you create great content. But I'm still in favor at the moment of creating unique and original content using my human writers and myself. But yeah, AI tools will help me develop that content quicker. There's no doubt about that. So that's my take on it. And it'll be interesting to see what others have to say in this video. Thanks, Alex, for inviting me.
What's up, blogging heroes? Today, I want to say what my favorite AI writers are and why. My first favorite is ZimWriter. If I want to get loads of content created and whack it on a site, get my editors to work on it and get it all uploaded, then ZimWriter is the one I'm going to use because it's the most price efficient option. And it does a really, really good job at just creating the bare bones articles that my writers can go in and just fix to make perfect for the site. If I want to get a one-shot blog post, then I'm using Koala Writer or Agility Writer. Both are great options, but they are also way more expensive. They don't have access to the same open AI that ZimWriter does. So where ZimWriter might cost 1 pence to 20 pence per article, Koala and Agility Writer will cost more like $1 to $3 per article as a direct result of it costing a lot more for the subscriptions, for word counts or credit accounts and things like that. So personally, I love using ZimWriter for loads of articles and Koala or Agility Writer for one-shot articles where I just want to get it perfect the first time. There you go, WP Eagle. I really hope this helped. AI is awesome. It's nothing to be scared of. Let's use it moving forward. This is Theo Ramwell, and you have a wonderful day.
I decided to stop paying for writers this year and am building a website completely with AI tools. And the one that I choose is ChatGPT. So far, I've created 12 articles, and they all rank, most of them on page one, for their primary keyword. I just monetized the site a few weeks ago, and it looks like it's making around 15 cents per day, and it might make $5 by the end of the month. I know there's other AI tools out there, but I prefer ChatGPT for its simplicity. I like being able to just feed it a prompt and wait for its response. I also like building the article slowly rather than having an entire article generated at once with the click of a button like a lot of AI tools do. It's very easy to make a paragraph more concise or more detailed with ChatGPT. I can also make the article or paragraph more engaging, more friendly, more humorous, whatever I want, just by copying the text and telling ChatGPT to modify it that way. ChatGPT is great because it's like having a writer for free, and I can tell it exactly what I want and get instant results. The articles I've created so far with ChatGPT have been very well made, they rank well, and they're earning money. I don't have a lot of experience with other tools, I've played around with them, but I definitely prefer ChatGPT. It's the first one that I've used, and it's the one that I've stuck with.
So there we go. Pretty interesting, huh? You'll find links to everyone that was in this video below. Go check them out. Go check out their socials, their YouTubes, whatever you like. And you'll also find links to all of the bits of software and tools that they mentioned down there too. Some of those links may be affiliate links. So thank you very much if you use them. Really appreciate it. But yeah, that's it. If you like this video, let YouTube know and me know by clicking the like button below. And of course, if you don't want to miss out on upcoming videos and live streams, make sure you're subscribed and click that bell. But until next time, good luck with your sites, friends. Bye for now.